Tim Shaw played football the same way he approaches life, devoted and determined.
Can't be half in. Either you're in or out. And so be all in. The game of football is just, it was just made for me, and I was made for it, and we had a great run.
His NFL run ended as a Tennessee Titan after 7 years and four teams. As special teams captain, teammates followed his kamikaze lead.
It's a dead focus. Nothing will keep me from the football. Nothing. Not one guy, not two. And when I get there, I'm gonna disrupt the football. I'm gonna separate that man from the football. I miss it.
Tim was cut before the 2013 season. He retired 7 months later on his 30th birthday. The following month, issues with his muscles led him to the doctor, where a different, destructive opponent emerged.
I was alone. They did a couple tests, and he came back in, and he said, Tim, I believe that you have ALS. And he said, I'd like you to get another opinion, but I believe you have it.
First thing that went through your mind was what?
Unbelief. And just wow. I thought about my family and just not wanting them to have to go through that.
Tim waited 4 months before sharing it publicly.
Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. It's been survived, but ALS slowly but surely takes away your functions and your nerves and your muscles, and ultimately they shut down. It is very feared, but it is not undefeated.
His online announcement came from the Titans headquarters. An ice bucket challenge downpour followed as his brotherhood of former teammates stood behind him.
Just such an amazing feeling to have those guys stand up with me was awesome. I feel a great sense of responsibility to impact this disease for those struggling with it now or in the future. And like, God has really put me here for a purpose. And what an amazing opportunity it is.
Tim was the type of guy that you would tell a young guy to go follow. What he's going through is gonna take a ton of mental toughness. And he probably learned a lot from this game.
There's a guy strong enough that can battle this and get through it. It's Tim. I still miss him, you know, now out on the field. There's just something about him.
Tim's workouts slow his muscle loss and deteriorating motor skills.
Trying to correct it and focused on going as hard as I can go.
And in these early stages of a physical and mental fight, his athletic and competitive pedigree rises.
You at some point have to lower your expectation based on where you came from. How do you accept that?
That's hard. I mean, Take the game of golf, which I love, and the score is not what it used to be, or I don't hit the ball as far as I used to hit it. And as an athlete, it keeps me driving to get back to where I used to be, whatever little way I can do every day.
Show me how good. Come on, get out there. Show me how good, brother.
Oh, I'll show you.
He did. More importantly, Tim's inner strength helps him handle the tough adjustments and unanswered questions ALS brings.
What's most daunting about the uncertainty of what's ahead?
Understanding that the odds say that I will one day be laying in a bed, unable to move a muscle, but fully mentally aware. But God has just shown me that He's got it. He's in control. The Bible says that the Lord determines, you know, what's gonna happen to us. I've really come to peace with that. And it's the freedom of giving up control. I never had control before a diagnosis. So why would I worry about when I'm gonna die, what's gonna happen to me? All I can do is live today.
Tim earned his recognition in stadiums, where it not only brought him notoriety, but it also shaped and sustained his name. But just like his career, well-being, and body, his identity has also been challenged in this transition.
I've been Tim the football player for a long time. When your identity is one thing and it's taken away, you don't know who you are. So ultimately, I found my identity in being just a child of God. Although my identity has shifted, it's really just become more solid. And I know who I am, and I know that God's created me. And so ALS doesn't define me.
His childlike resilience and ironclad strength sustains him for a fight that also requires surrender.
We all have unanswered questions. I'm not God. There are some things that we will not understand ever, but I know this, God uses any circumstance, and in my life, it's a mystery, it's a puzzle. It's not what I want, but it's mine. It's my privilege to walk this out.
Like in footsteps that recently walked in Brazil on a mission trip with his dad, drilling wells in distant places that bring him close, meaningful gestures of love and support.
13-year-old Brazilian girl in the middle of the Amazon jungle telling me that she's been praying for me for 3 months and that she doesn't want anything bad to happen to me. Being prayed on in a church with no walls in 4 different languages, that is God saying, I love you to the fullest. And I had to bring you all the way out into the middle of the jungle to show you that. God shifts your perspective that would never be shifted if you didn't step out in that uncomfortable space.
Tim Shaw, tackler extraordinaire, who grips disease as he fights for life while fully living it.
And it's that relationship. It's that belief that a God can love you despite every sickness in my body and every sin that I've ever committed. He loves me anyways. And that's what God is to me, man. He wipes my garbage away. He takes my ALS and he holds it in his hand and he says, Tim, I got you. I got you to the fullest. There are so many good things that he's done. Don't curse him in the bad times. He's there.